Well, hey guys, good morning. Big A coming to you live from the station Camp Greenway. Hope you're having a great day. What a great weekend it was. What a beautiful day that we're having today. Hey, I titled this, I was nervous at first, but it's worth it. And I'm going to tell you right now, before I even talk about this topic, there's only going to be a small percentage of you guys do this. But I want to kind of tell you a little backstory, what made me talk about this. I've been an entrepreneur now 40 years. Man, I think back over that and I think that's gone by like that sometimes, and sometimes it feels like it's been an eternity. But let me tell you what it is. It's vacations, and I want to talk about our vacation season as it approaches us. Many of you guys are getting ready to take a vacation. And years ago, I would always like get up early, do my work, make my calls, and then kind of engage with the family. Well, over the course of our marriage, Robin and I have talked about this at great length, and she said, why can't you just not work on vacations? And I'm like, well, they're counting on me, and we've got these businesses, and I've got to see to it. And what I come to discover is that I could do that early. I'd get up before the kids would get up, and I would work, and I would make phone calls and answer emails and do that kind of thing. But what it was doing was affecting the whole morning, not because I was working, it's because I was thinking about the problems. I was thinking about the situations that our team was dealing with, and it distracted me. And so I wasn't a lot of fun to be around with the kids because I was distracted. And so, make a long story short, it was really affecting our vacations. Robin was like, you know, you got this on your mind, now it's messed up our morning, and now you have to deal with this problem. The kids want to go to the beach, or they want to do whatever, and we can't because you got to deal with this problem. So I started thinking about it, and I said, well, I'll kind of sneak around and check my messages and check this and check that, and I just won't say anything about it. Well, that was worse. Then I felt terrible. It was like, man, I can't be sneaking around working and making phone calls. And so about 4 years ago, we were going to go on a trip. We were taking a cruise, Robin and I. We were going down through the Panama Canal, and my kids encouraged me to do this as well. Robin said, why don't you just leave your phone at home? And I'm like, what? There's no way I can leave my phone at home. My kids encouraged me to do that as well. They said, come on, Dad, just leave your phone at home. My kids were already grown by this time, obviously, but said, you and Mom need some time away. And so I did it. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'll never in the world survive this. Well, I did. And when I got back, everything wasn't all blown up like I thought it was going to be. Left my laptop at home. I'll be going on vacation soon, and I'll be doing the same thing. I'll be leaving my phone at home, turned off in the desk. I'll leave my laptop at home. There's no distractions. Well, here's the thing. You say, there's no way. I can hear some of you right now saying, there is no way I could do that. Well, I didn't think so either. I thought, you know, they need me, I'm that important. Well, here's what I soon discovered. The business owns you. You don't own the business if you can't get away for about a week, maybe 10 days. Leave the phone at home this year. Just try it. Just trust me. Just go, man, I'm glad I did that. Big A gave me some good advice. Just try it one time. Here's what we do. Robin's got a phone, obviously. The kids can get a hold of us, or any of the grandkids in case of an emergency. But things are not going to be just havoc when you get back. Michael Hyatt did something about 2 years ago that was pretty impressive to me. He left an autoresponder on his email. He said, I'm going to be traveling in Europe for about 30 days. And he said, when I get back, I'm going to hit the delete button on all my emails. They will not be read. They will not be responded to. He said, because when you're gone that long, it's already taken care of to begin with. And so I'm not going to waste a week answering emails that we really don't need to do. Guys, I want to tell you something. You'll be more present. And Robin told me that first year when we got back from that cruise. She said, this was the most enjoyable trip I've ever taken because I had your undivided attention. I was able to have you in your entirety. Like, you weren't distracted by work and the problems. Listen, we've got to take some time off. You've got to take a break. You've got to rest a little bit, and you can't do it. I did it. I tried it for years. I tried, you know, being able to do both. I come back more refreshed now. I'm rested. The other thing is that if you can't do that, you're not setting up proper procedures in your business. You need to revisit that. You need to revisit why you can't take off for an extended period of time and come back and everything be okay. So I just want to encourage you this year, 2018, just try it. If it's a weekend, if it's a week-long trip, just try to leave your devices at home turned off and you watch your vacation. It will be much more enjoyable. Well, I better get back to my walk. I'm Big A, coming to you live from the Station Camp Greenway. You guys leave comments down below and let me know if you're going to take this challenge this year and leave your phone and your devices at home. We'll see you.